You know, what is a gene?
Well, let's be clear. I'm going to give a very simple answer, actually, David. Let's be clear, nobody knows. However, let me clarify that statement just a little, because I don't think you'll be satisfied with that. It's defined today, of course, in terms of DNA, and nobody can doubt the importance of the genome. I think, though, it's been misdescribed. It's best described as a database used by organisms to enable them to generate the functions that you and I and others study as physiology. And what we have to remember, in opposition to the gene-centric view, is that in order for that to be the case, we inherit much more than our DNA. We inherit, number one, the whole of cell structure, which is self-templating. It doesn't need DNA to self-template. Many of you probably don't know, cells can actually divide without a nucleus. We inherit many forms of RNAs, which determine part of the way in which the genome is interpreted. We inherit many forms of epigenetic marking, and I don't need to tell this audience how big the field of epigenetics has now become. We also inherit behavioral marking of the genome. There are examples of all of these. Those are what we necessarily inherit in the short term, generation to generation to generation. In the longer term, even more fundamental changes are inherited in changes in the genome itself, with various forms of genome reorganization in response to challenges from the environment. So I think the short answer, David, is we inherit much more than DNA. DNA is extremely important. Sequencing is very important too, but it's not the be-all and end-all of understanding function in physiological systems.